Hello dear learners, my name is Priya Bora, Assistant Professor, Department of Tourism, Uttarakhand Open University. So today we will be learning about different tourism models. We will be learning about the different patterns of tourism, tourism industry and the tourist behavior. So today we will be learning about LEPR's geospatial model and DOXI's IRIDEX index. To understand tourism in a more systematic way, the various theories and models were given by the known pioneers of tourism. Tourism is not only limited to the destinations, cultural sites, hotels, restaurants, or recreational activities, but is also the combination of various elements and has the interdependent relationship. LEPR's geospatial model. It was given by Neil LEPR in 1979 and later updated in 1990. LEPR's model is widely regarded as a valuable tool for understanding tourism as a system. Tourism was from early thought to be a simple single sector, but it has since been shown to be a highly complicated industry that cannot be viewed as a single unit. LEPR's contribution to the details was the adoption of the system's approach towards understanding tourism. LEPR defined tourism as the system involving the discretionary travel and temporary stay of persons away from their usual place of residence for one or more nights, excepting tours for made for the primary purpose of learning remuneration from points en route. The elements of the system are tourist generating regions, transit route region, destination region, and the tourist industry. These five elements are arranged in spatial and functional connections. Having the characteristics of an open system, the organization of five elements operates within broader environment: physical, cultural, social, economical, political, technological, and which it interacts. Now, LEPR divided the models into various components, which are the human component, that is the very first component, which included the tourist, and it helped us to understand what tourists actually are. The geographical component, which included the three most subcontinents, that are traveler generating regions, TGR, transit route region, TRR, tourist destination region, TDR. The industrial component, tourism industry is the main component under this. Then we have the last one, environmental component. Now the human component. The human element comprises of tourist. UNWTO has defined tourist as a temporary visitor intending to spend overnight at a destination away from his usual place of residence for purposes such as leisure, business, and recreation. A tourist must be motivated to undertake travel. Following are the categories of the people who are not counted as tourists. These categories include people who arrive at a destination to engage in any business activity, undertake any certain kind of education, any traveler traversing a country at regions without having any intent to stay there will not be considered as tourist. Another category is excursionist, who are temporary visitors for a period of less than 24 hours in the country visited. Tourists are net users of economic resources in the region they are visiting. After touring, they return to their original place of residence or their place of departure. Now here we are looking over the diagram which completely describes about the tourist LEPR model. That is, we are having our three regions in front of us, that is traveler generating region, transit route region, tourist destination region. The geographical component refers to the geographical area involved in the tourism process. Tourists depart from TGR, which is traveler generating region, also the place of origin, utilize TRR, the transit route region, and reach TDR, which is tourist destination region, also the place of arrival. Now we will discuss one by one about these all three regions. Traveler generating regions. Tourism generating region refers to the place where the tourist starts and ends his tour. These are influenced by the social, psychological, and economical forces generated from within the person. The aspects like monotonous environment, exploration, self-evaluation, relaxation, prestige, family relations, and social interactions are found within the minds of the people of the tourist generating region. Now, the demographic aspects like age, sex, educational qualification, income, and marital status also contributes to the push factors. The economic push factors are the disposable income added with the available leisure time joined together that play vital role in the tourist generating region. Apart from the above mentioned factors in the tourist generating region, the aspects like ticketing services, tour operators, travel agents, and marketing and promotional activities present in the departure area play a major role as push components. Now we will discuss about transit route region, the region which links TGR with TDR. Evidently, there is a distance between the TGR and TDR. This region is called as transit route region. The transit route enables the tourist to change flight or stop for some time for refuel. The transit route may be crossed with the different types of transportation like air transportation or rail transportation or water transportation or road transportation or a combination of all these types of transports according to the necessity of the tourist. Now we will discuss about tourist destination region. Tourist destination region is the place which traveler ultimately seeks to visit. It acts as a pull force for the tourist. This component includes the natural attractions, cultural attractions, and various entertainment factors. Accommodation, facilities, services, amenities, safety and security available in the destination of visit that ultimately pull the tourist. Now we will discuss about the another component, that is the industrial component. Businesses and organizations that market tourism related items are referred to as the industrial component. These firms focus on catering to the needs and desires of tourists because tourism cannot function without even one part of the industrial component. The tourist industry is not a separate entity, and all of its industrial components work together. The industries which it comprises of are tourism attraction industry, transportation industry, entertainment industry, accommodation industry, and the last, shopping industry. Now, the last component we will discuss, the environment component. Tourism is a system that interacts with the external environment. Environment surroundings these three regions are TGR, TRR, TDR affect the tourism system and vice versa. These factors either induce positive or negative influences on the tourism system. The environmental components that affect the tourism system are as follows. These are political factors, economic factors, social and cultural factors, technological factors, environmental factors, and legal factors. We will discuss these factors in a more brief manner. Political factors. Political considerations have an impact on the tourist system depending on the current political culture. If there is political peace and law and order in properly implemented, the tourism system will operate efficiently. Social and cultural factors. Tourists from the originating region will be drawn to the tourism destination region based on the attitude of the locals. The welcoming nature of the destination's host determines the tourist experiences. Now we have economic factors. Generally, the tourists only prefer those destinations which are quite affordable and where they can visit soon. Last, technological factors. Technology has altered visitor behavior in the producing region, and tourism sector organizations are utilizing technology to advertise their services and goods in the tourist destination region. For example, instead of engaging travel agencies and tour operators, Tourists utilize the internet to obtain information on destination, transport routes and attractions before making travel plans, for making bookings online and etc. Environmental factors. Tourists from the producing region and tourism industry operations have an impact on the destination region's ecology. Negative effects like pollution, loss of greenery, overcrowding and overuse increase the need for tourism to be sustainable in the future. As a result, such negative effects must be removed or decreased by the government, raising knowledge about the sustainability of tourist resources or the tourist system would suffer serious losses. Now last, that is the legal factors. The prevailing law and order in the tourist producing regions, transit route regions and tourist destination region are referred to as legal elements. It results in the proper growth and administration of tourism and the tourism system components. These are regulations governing tourism, infrastructure, natural biodiversity conservation and cultural resources. Now the second model, that is Doxey's Iridex model. It is also known as Doxey's Irritation Index model, given in 1975. As the effects of a developing tourist sector in the region becomes more prominent and the opinions of tourist as well as host community alter with experience and with the passage of time, so this model argues that communities go through a series of stages. It justifies locals' views during various stages of a tourist destination's development. Also, it evaluates the interactions and relationships between the host and visitor. The model implies that the entire community becomes unfriendly to tourism. Although communities are typically diverse with various sectors of the community reacting differently. As the nature of tourism in the area grow increasingly, these stages parallel the more generally applicable product life cycle and are therefore accompanied by increasingly negative consequences on the local population. Here we can see the various stages. The graph is going downwards. The first stage we see is euphoria, the second is apathy, then irritation or annoyance, and the last one is antagonism. We will discuss about series of these, all the stages. So the first one is euphoria. In this stage, welcoming of the visitors is done by the host community. Destination have a few visitors, good and informal communication between the locals and the tourist happens. Locals get excited to see all the tourists. They want to interact with the tourist and be extra helpful to them. This is what happens when the new destination is being made and the host community wants to communicate with the tourist as they have never seen one before. The second stage is apathy. The destination continues to get developed with the passage of time. Now this is the stage where tourist doesn't seem to be new to the host community and they get used to them. The locals doesn't get too bothered by the tourist and doesn't believe that they are cool and different. Tourists are only seen as a source of money. The locals are not interested to communicate with the tourist as they are rarely concerned about them. We have the third stage, that is annoyance or irritation. Destination has gained the saturation point. Development of tourist attraction and tourist related services can be seen everywhere, leading to overdevelopment. This annoys the locals and they are irritated with the tourist visiting their destination. Lack of resources for the locals. Then we have the last stage, that is antagonism. The overdevelopment is leading negative impact. The host community blames the tourist and tourism industry for all the negative impacts. Irritation openly expressed as physically and verbally. All over, tourist is seen as the cause of the problem. So here in both the models, we all discussed about the various effects that the tourist is causing to a certain host community and the tourism industry effects. So in the next part, we will discuss about Mill Morrison and the Butler Tourism Area Life Cycle. Thank you.